Okay, and then even going one step further inside of our studio. This is all modular. So if you have a PadLab 7, you are able to add 3D and video anyway. And then if you want to continue with a studio, you can add ball tracking. You might add Balance Lab, or you might add even a tiltable platform. So now working with ball tracking, and this is maybe extending a little bit more than you normally would do in a normal setup. This would be more the studio setup where you would upgrade your putting lab into a true putting studio, as we were presenting in Orlando. So it is a setup where we would now have the ability to do very different things around putting, which is much more than just only looking at your putting stroke. So we already integrated the Balance Lab, or we are even able now to integrate maybe other technology, which is not yet done, but in the end, ground reaction forces can be added, so you see actually what your balance does. This can also be replayed on the same timescale, just the same as video or as 3D. And then if you have different screens, you might have 3D in front here, you might have PadLab here, Balance Lab here, high-speed video here, and then we have a ball tracking system, which is simply a camera which is mounted to a ceiling at a height of about 2.5 to 3 meters. There's not much needed to install it. It's just high-speed camera and a USB cable running to your computer. That's basically it. Certainly, it's much more fun and much more exciting to use ball tracking in conjunction with tiltable surfaces, or with a putting surface which can be tilted manually. There are different options. So we have the option to integrate with a tiltable putting surface like the Putting Perfection platform in the US or Zen Oracle in Europe. Different options where we automatically calibrate everything relative to the actual pitch and roll. So you don't need to take care of anything. You don't need to recalibrate. Even if you play different targets, you don't need to recalibrate. So that's very easy to be used. So you just put it to a different position. You select a different hole, and then you are ready to go. And then we are able to, one, calculate the optimum corridors. We can give you a lot of feedback on details of your stroke, but we can also in the future project this down to the surface, which is not yet completely done, but which is under work and will be ready in summer. So there will be a projector also projecting everything onto the surface, like your corridors, like animated balls, aim positions, speed cues, funnels, games, whatever it is. So we will have this available in summer. And now you have a complete environment around putting where everything is available. What is a strata? Calibration is different on a calibration. You always calibrate to the center of this surface. So you have a specific reference position, which is in the center. So you calibrate the station to one spot, which is in the center. And then you know where the holes are relative to this center position. And this can be seen if you look through the camera, you bring the camera onto your screen, then you see where the holes are. So you just select the holes once, and then they are stored. And then you see, okay, now I want to play to the right hole. And then you don't need to recalibrate, because this is all just then seen relative to your new target. So there's no more calibration needed. You just calibrate once to a center position, and then we might project new holes, artificial holes, at any position on the green, at any tilt angle. And this is than certainly a gaming environment. Phase at address and impact will be different. No, everything will be just zero for this new ideal putt. So everything is just turned around. So if I look at, let us look at some data sets to make it more clear. So we look at a data set which is, okay, let's scroll up. Ball tracker. So this would be a data set, 2 degrees of rolls left and right, zero pitch, so no up and down, but the hole is having an offset to the right by 0.5 meters. So this would not be to the center of the surface. It's a hole which is 0.5 meters offsetted to the right. And then we look at the report, ball tracking report. And what we see then is that relative to this ideal aim line, which is now calculated as being 7.2 degrees to the left, and you would need a ideal speed, starting speed of the ball of 5 miles per hour. And then relative to this ideal aim, we would look at your aim angle, and we would look at your starting direction of the ball. So all the data in SemPutLab is now just turned by 7.2 degrees. So this would be your new zero angle. So if I look at SemPutLab data in here, your face would be then for this part 0.4 degrees closed relative to the ideal aim. Okay, this is relative to the ideal aim. So all the data will now be corresponding to your new target. So zero is no longer the connection from the ball to the hole. It is relative to any target on the surface. That's the aiming point. The ideal aiming point is at 7.2 to the left, which is indicated by the red line here. Now let's look for one single putt, and let's say take maybe putt number 5. I hope you can see that. This is putt number 5. It almost perfectly started on the calculated ideal aim line. And then we see it was 0.6 degrees to the left, the ball starting relative to the ideal aim line, and it was calculated as being slightly slow. But it still roughly matched up with this corridor. And then relative to this putt, we can not only give this feedback to allow you to then start practicing. So there is not this one optimum corridor. It's more a range, and we have a range between the fastest putt and the slowest putt. And the fastest putt is 0.9 meters per second entry speed. The slowest putt is 0.1 meter per second entry speed. The ideal putt is 0.5 entry speed. You might select a different entry speed because you want to be a little bit more fast, but actually, at 0.5 meter per second entry speed, your hole size is still at 95%, I think, which is a good balance between not reducing the width or size of the hole and don't make the putt maybe too slow. So we selected a size of the hole which is still acceptable with 95%. To be the optimum entry speed. We might also look at the distance past the hole, which is again calculated and which can also be then maybe selectable in the future. We don't have it here, but we might do it selectable. Well, the percent slope is 2%. So if I had a 3% slope, I would enter it into the software, yes, or if you have a tilting platform, it would be automatically selected because we would control the platform with the same software. But if you have a fixed slope, let's say you have a surface and you can tilt it, and you can put something underneath so that you come up with 2.5%, you just enter it into the software and then you are done. And then you can go. So you can also do it with a manual tilt of your putting surface. So actually we are building these manual platforms because they are quite cheap and the automatic platforms are a little bit expensive. Just to start with, you might use a manual one. Basically, the fun you have with the automatic one is just unbelievable. So it depends on your budget. But just to start with getting into this, you might simply use a manually tilted surface. Okay, maybe shortly what we can do with this ball tracking data also. So this would be kind of a training screen. And for each putt, you would see now your score for direction, your score for speed. So you would directly see the higher score is matching better with the ideal, which we have calculated. So there was more deviation with regards to pace for this putt. For putt number four, we would have much more deviation for pace here. Yeah, so you can just look for any putt. Okay, this was just very poor one. So sometimes we test it and we do something which is weird just to check what's going on. But for this putt, you might say, well, reasonable angle, but speed needs to be slightly faster. And then on the right side, we combine both information. So the gray range is theoretically the range you could hold it. And then the gray range here is kind of the combination. So if the dot is close to the gray area or even inside of the gray area, then you have a good chance to hold this putt. Actually, this dot should touch the gray area as you were almost perfectly keeping it on the corridor. And then we have fitting data available relative to ball speed, launch speed, relative direction, smash factor, skid distance, skid time, speed drop, roll speed, roll ratio, roll distance, ball side position, and effective stimp, which is actually not the stimp of your surface. Only if it would be flat, it would be the stimp of your surface. Actually, this is the stimp of the actual putt on a break, which is different because in the beginning it goes uphill and then afterwards it goes downhill. So this is kind of an effective stimp, which needs to be interpreted a little bit differently. And then we have ball speed curves. So this would be the ball speed curve where you would see, well, okay, skid phase, you see the speed drop, which is more significant in the skid phase, and then it starts getting into a constant decrease of speed once it starts with pure rolling. So we can then calculate the roll speed and the speed drop from up here down to here, and the roll ratio, and so on and so on. And you see here, there is a dotted line underneath, and this is why we start continuing this putt at the roll speed after impact of something. So maybe this ball smashed against another ball. So basically it ended up here. If we want to calculate, let's say for accuracy of distance control, we can continue a simulation where we let the ball roll even past an object where it went against. And then we have combined tables for putlab data and ball tracking data, which would be used to optimize the specs on putters, for example. Okay, Matt Blair asks, is there an effective way of measuring what length should be without a camera? Well, actually, if you play breaking putts, I simply put a tee behind the hole And then if you miss the hole, you see where the ball is going. And then relative to the tee behind the hole, I put a tee at the apex or a coin at the apex. And if you go over the apex, then you have probably got the right length of the putt, if this was the question. So this is all what we will do in the future with a ball tracking system inside of our studios, that we will provide different information like apex, like distance past the hole, and we give you more difficult tasks like playing less or more speed relative to the ideal. So there's not only one ideal, to put it that way. If we test different, even tour players on the same putt, they use different trade-offs between break and speed. There's not this one ideal. That's a little bit theoretical. Some tend to use more speed and take out break, and others do it the opposite way. Many players have different strategies, left or right, and right to left breaking putts, so they change relative to the side they play. But to get accurate feedback on that and to find out if this is functional, I think this setup helps dramatically. So these graphs are available in the Putt software, the Putt Studio software, but they are also available in 3D. So just the same putt which we've seen here can also be looked at in the 3D software. So we can replay the same putt in 3D. Okay, let's speed it up a little bit, 50%. So this is now the same putt. You see it rolling. You can look at it from different perspectives. You can look at it from the hole, for example. The red would be now the ideal aim line or starting line. You see how the ball gets access to the hole, and you can amplify this certainly. You can travel with a ball, let's say in a gaming mode. You might even travel with a ball to see the ball rolling. You have split screens where on the upper half you can display a regular display like face angle. So we can go to face angle up here. And in the lower screen, you would see the ball rolling. Now, again, this is at an angle where zero is now the ideal aim, which is not the target line, it's the aim line. So everything is now relative to the aim line, which is the red line down here. So there are a lot of options to play around to really visualize what's going on. And that's true action of the ball. Again, you can combine this with video and so on and so on. So there are a lot of options. Okay, I think we have gone through all of this. If you want to have more information, we will send you maybe some brochure on that. Do you have any questions? Well, the projection, yeah. Please ask Corona. We plan to have it ready end of June. And now everything is a little bit different, as you know. We have some problems here in Germany, as we have all over the world. So things are delayed. So definitely in summer, it needs to be ready. So the basically, the problem is not the projection itself. That's easy. We already have it done. I think what needs to be worked through is also integrating it into an environment where everything is just seamless. That's a little bit what we are still working on, to make it very comfortable, very efficient. So I'm sure it will be ready summer, which might be July, August. It depends a little bit on the development inside of the next months, to be honest. So if we continue like this, things are a little bit critical, as you know. Yeah, so Glenn Coomb says, amazing changes since we began with Sam. Yeah, well, basically, if we look back 15 years, nobody believed us that there is any sense in working in the field of putting with technology measuring the stroke. And things has changed so much. Things have changed that dramatically. So we were opening a window, and so I think now we are just continuing to add more more options for your teaching coaching. So we are very amazed of all these things. Yeah. So David asks about the FLIR camera. I'm not exactly sure. It depends a little bit on the model. Please just write us. I think basically it comes with a package where everything is included. So I think the for the ball tracking, the camera is part of the package. If you want to have a FLIR camera for ball tracking, for high-speed video, there are different options. Please just ask us via email. I'm not aware of all the developments, actually. Okay, if there are no more questions, I at least stop the recording. Thank you very much for being part of the demonstration. If you have any recommendations, any comments, any feedback, it can also be critical. We don't care. You are our customers. We want to make you happy. Please let us know. Let us know. Will PadLab 7 integrate with GASP? I don't know, actually. I have no idea. We go a little bit different route, so it might continue going with GASP, but not with the functionality we have here. So it might be reduced in function. I don't know. Okay, Stefan, yeah, I will have a good beer. Thank you very much. Okay, so then, as I said, thanks to all of you. Great to have a community of guys like you behind SamPadLab. We keep on going, and we will be back live shortly. So I'm amazed getting all this to work, including projection. There are so many options, and you will be on board. And we would love then to get all your feedback and to do it in the best way we could do to make it really extending everything to your needs. So I'm very amazed about all that. So thank you very much. And yes, if you don't have considered upgrading to 7, I think that's now a good point to do it, because then you will be part of further development. Well, cost of the platform, that's, yeah, difficult. Actually, because it is not only the platform, it's also shipment, it's installment. There are a lot of things around. There are different sizes. So it's I think in the US it's roughly about $20,000, including everything. There are also cheaper options available, and there's also a half automatic platform available, but that's still an expensive part. We will see what the future brings. Prices might go down if there are more customers. We don't know yet. Basically, this is not our product. The platform is product of cooperation partners. In the US, it is Putting Perfection platform. You might just try to find it on your own, or you go to our website or write us a mail and we send you informational platform. So for Europe, we are not quite sure. Putting Perfection platform is able to deliver to Europe as far as we know. And then there might be other options like the Zen Oracle Green Stage, but unfortunately, this is also slightly expensive, even more expensive maybe. Very nice design, but also expensive. And there might be other manufacturers popping up in the near future. We will see. So at least in Europe, there might be different options in the near future. So, but nothing yet available. So we will have an eye on that and we keep you informed. So once there are more options, we will let you know. Well, the split screen was done. Well, you might just resize your windows and put it on this position. But in PubLab 7, you have the option to select it in the studio. So if I say I have 3D PUD software and I have a video software, you can dock it somewhere. You can say I want to dock it to the top left and to the bottom right, or to the top and the bottom. So I could do, okay, top and bottom. Let's say it's already there. Not yet. Okay, I need to maybe do this. Okay, I think I need to close it first and then it gets to its new position. But these two positions basically come from my definition in here. So when I select it, dock it left for Sense 3D part and dock it right. And then it would automatically dock in this position once it opens up. So this is all controlled by the Studio App Control Center. Okay. So thank you very much. Not sure when I can meet you next time, but we keep contact. We keep you informed. Keep on reading our newsletter where we will try to give you some more information on our development. And as I said, feedback is always appreciated much. So please, if there's something you would recommend where you can criticize some things which are not optimal, please let us know. We are always dedicated to improve our products. You are our customers. You know best what works out, what not. So thank you very much. And until soon, all the best.